Hey guys, this is Brian Bachkiller, and this is a video I meant to do for a while, and I just had a good reason to do it because I was laying down some drums and on my electronic kit, and my snare just stopped working. So what I'm going to tell you how to do here is how to replace the triggers inside of your electronic drum kit. And you know, this is going to differ from kit to kit, but in my experience, this is about the same in a lot of them. What most electronic drum triggers use is just a really simple little thing called a piezo transducer. And that's a fancy name for contact mic. And this is the same thing that you see when you go check out like an electronic drum trigger. It's basically a very small piece of metal. And all it does is pick up on vibrations from a drum or anything else, or in this case, the stick hitting the electronic drum head, and it picks it up and sends it down the wires, and then everything gets turned into an electronic drum sound. Problem is, these things like to die a lot, and they die because they're not really meant to have this happen to them, in all honesty. I mean, you know, this is kind of the kind of wear and tear that is going to happen as you use your electronic kit. So if you have a kit like I do, I play on a Pintech 6-piece, and if you have a kit like I do, you probably have these kinds of triggers. So here's the cool thing. You can replace these really easily. All you need is a Radio Shack piezo transducer, and I don't know if you can see that, but the serial number on these guys is 273-073. You can get these when you go into Radio Shack. Radio Shack doesn't really have a lot of cool stuff that they used to, but what they do have are these large drawers full of all kinds of gear, and it's various things, knobs, dials, so on and so forth. You want to find the buzzers drawer, and because this is considered a buzzer. Usually what this does is it gets a signal sent to it and it just buzzes. It's like a little tiny speaker. But you want to get one of these, and you can get them for about $3-4 a piece, so it's not too bad. And I've already started working on this one. As you can see, it's in this plastic packaging or little case here. You don't want that on there. You want the actual transducer. So what you want to do is take a screwdriver or something like that and just pry at this plastic until you're able to get it off. And once you start getting it, it's going to come off fairly easily. Yeah, there you go. So now that's our transducer right there. Now, the only other tricky thing here is getting this thing out. And the only way I've found to really do that, take your screwdriver, put it through this hole that's on the front, move it to the edge of the transducer as far as you can, and then just push lightly. And you're going to bend it a little bit, unfortunately. That's going to happen. But they can usually take in with a good pop. You should hear it pry out. And you can see now it's already coming. There it is. Okay, so now that we've got this guy coming out, we're just going to finish getting this out of here. Okay, boom. That's our brand new transducer. You can see I've already done this before. This is my old one. Here's my new one. Not too much of a difference between them, except that this one's taken a serious beating and this one is brand spanking new. So, what we need to do now is take this and wire it back into our drum. Now, this is where, let me get some light here. We're going to go with the headlamp because it makes life a little bit easier. All right. We're going to put on our trusty headlamp. You'll probably need these if you're going to start doing any work like this yourself. Now, inside of your drum, you're going to find inside of the usual padding that's inside of it, a couple look like old speaker wires, the kind that you would use connecting up like an old home stereo or something like that. These are the wires you need to connect your transducer back to. In the case of my kit, the copper-colored wire is the negative, which is the black wire. And the silver is the positive, which is the red. This doesn't always matter. You don't always need to worry about this, but it's if you can match them, it's best. Now, you're going to need to pull some of the plastic sheathing off of this transducer here. And I find, you know, you can get as many fancy pants, you know, wire strippers as you want, but in all honesty, I find that the best ones are still my fingernails, or behind that, my teeth. I This one's being a little bit of a pain in the butt. There we go. That's what we want to see. Like I say, use your teeth, guys. It never hurts. Alright. Because you know what? I honestly find the most wire strippers just don't work very well. Alright. I have to get a little bit of that plastic sheathing off. You want to just twist these wires up real good. And in a lot of cases, they'll be already fairly twisted. But just get them twisted up. Now that that's done, you want to just connect this back to the drum. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my wires again. My copper is my negative, and I'm just going to twist them together. This can be a little tight working space too. You know, give yourself as much space as you can, because I find very often that these pieces of foam inside of these drums are pretty tightly wound in there, and the wires run up through them and things like that. Okay, so there's our negative, and we're going to do our positive as well. Cool. Alright, so everything's twisted back together. That's good. Now, the other thing you're going to need is going to be some electrical tape, which I had. There we go. Electrical tape. Now, you know, electrical tape is easy to get. You can get it at Radio Shack, you can get it at Walmart, you can get it anywhere. Grab a good piece of electrical tape, pull it off, and then just cover this wire up. Because you don't want these two touching. If they touch, you are not going to get signal. They're going to cancel each other out. This is the same thing as if we connect two speaker wires together, they cancel each other out, because this is, again, essentially just a, it's just a speaker jammed inside of a drum. So we got our positive covered. Let's cover our negative as well. You don't have to be too fancy about this or anything like that, but just, you know, get it covered well enough so that you know that this isn't going to come loose, because remember, you're going to be hitting this thing quite a lot. Okay. After you've got these all covered up, you can push your cable, your wire, back in as much as possible. I find it's a little hard because I've been pulling these things in and out so much. But that should be all that you really need to do. Now, the transducer really doesn't need to go in any specific direction, but I find that I like to put the side that the wires connect to facing up to the top of my drum to where I'm going to be hitting. And what you can also do, and I'll just reuse the piece that I have here, grab yourself some double stick tape of some kind, stick that onto the back of the transducer, and then just slide it in and just kind of press down to get it to stick. And sometimes it won't, it's, you know, this foam really makes it hard, but anything you can do to just get that transducer stick in there is going to get the better, going to get you a better triggering capability out of that piezo. And that's really it, guys. That's all that you really need to do. Now, you know, in some cases, like this drum also has a trigger on the inside on the rim, and that's so that I can get rim shots and things like that. These ones can be a little bit more of a bear because they're usually glued in. So if you find that that one's going out, you know, you're going to have to replace it again in the same fashion, but you may have to hot glue it back onto the edge of your drum. But that's really it. This is also a great chance to clean your drum out. You see I have all kinds of foam and stuff in there. And when you're done with that, just take your drum head, and I'm using these pearl muffle heads. They're usually meant for muffling analog kits, just regular trap kits, but I use these on my electronic kits because they are way cheaper than your average electronic drum head. Unfortunately, they die kind of easily. See, I've already punched a couple holes, so I've put some Gorilla Tape on there. But put that head back on, tighten it down nicely, and test it out. And if it does not work, then that could mean that you have a wiring problem or something like that. And if that's the case, you know, you may need to just redo your wiring, but again, these are really simple when you come right down to it. I mean, it's a very simple setup, And the only thing that's going to get in your way is the fact that those transducers like to die really, really easily and very often. So, anyway, there you go, guys. I hope it's helpful. Electronic drumming is a pain in the butt sometimes, but it can be made easier and less expensive if you're smart about it. So, hope you guys found that useful, and stay in touch with me at brianbotkiller.com. Check out my other videos on drum tips and drumming and so on and so forth, and I'll see you guys next time. Take it easy. You've read life.